you have heard, is something to do with the alleged, the purported tuition increment across the board in the university. I'm underlining the word purported, I'll give a meaning and context to it. But other than that, before we had a series of engagement with the students' community, just the Saturday before the Tuesday that the students started the demonstration, the university management led by the substantive vice chancellor and his team met out the guild leadership, the guild president, and the DRC, the guild representative council. And they had a number of issues they were raising. One of them was that some of them had not got time to register in time and pay fees, and therefore, but also the system of registration online, occasionally it would go. That was one of the issues they raised. And now they feared that the university was going to invoke its policy. As you know, if you have not paid the fees by the 12th week, then any balance is attracting a surcharge, okay, of 5%. So, of course, that was one of the matters. The other one was to do with some rehabilitation. There were concerns about the rehabilitation of some facilities in the halls of residence. The other one was to do with the concern that the policy and guidelines to the guild elections that were passed and gazetted by council prior to last year's elections, that they did not agree with them, and then they wanted these policies and guidelines in guild elections to be reversed. Yeah, so all of that was listened to. I think there was some one or two colleges that complained about their results not being updated on the system. So those were the matters. Now, all of the other matters were almost immediately addressed by the management led by the vice chancellor, and it was agreed that this surcharge is going to be exempted for this semester. Of course, on the understanding that occasionally we are under the system, the AIMS, Academic Information Management System, and there was a bit of integration with the other stakeholders like NITRU and also the Uganda Revenue Authority, because this is the fees payment system. And that integration will cause some kind of intermittences occasionally. So it was agreed that okay, that surcharge, and immediately surcharge went. So it was approved following a report that was presented by the previous guild cabinet, which did a study, a benchmark study, in universities around the region to establish whether it was really the best of the fees and the percentages that the university had made in a decision.